Yeah, I'm not very good prepared because I didn't read the email properly. I thought I get invited to a symposium, but I thought only to listen. I didn't know that I have to actually talk. But yeah, I was quite. Yeah, I will talk about myself because that's my only expertise actually, and I enjoy talking about myself because I think I'm a genius and yeah, the best person in the universe and. Yeah, and I felt quite intimidated by this whole very academic, theoretical speeches yesterday. Yeah, like I thought, oh my God, they're all nerds. Fuck, what can I do there? Yes, I'm talking about my work. Yeah, and I thought I have to say, I don't see myself as a poet, actually. I see myself more as a clown. But I don't think it's this ex excludes it, it it's it it ex excludes each other. I mean, you can also be a poetic clown or something. Yeah, because I do jokes in the internet mostly, and I like the role as a clown the most because yeah, you can speak truth and tell everyone how much you hate them, but still everybody loves you for that, and you get. Attention and appreciation, and I really like appreciation. Because yeah, I enjoyed in the internet because when I write on the internet, yesterday I took a shit or something, I get like 300 likes, and if I do it in bars, I just get kicked out every time. So I like the internet and yeah. Well, this one, yeah, and I write a lot on Facebook. I don't know if it's smart, but I didn't find an alternative to it till now. And yeah, and I'm just writing about my everyday life and my thoughts and yeah, make some jokes. And I wanted to show a video. Dieses Instagram-Video, wo ich zum Supermarkt gehe. Ich weiß nicht, auf Facebook ist es. Ja, also ich habe es bei mir habe ich es geladen, aber. Okay. Yeah, and in the last days I made some videos because I have a new phone and I can make good videos now. And I think it's a good explanation of what I'm doing. I made a video about going to the supermarket and I will show you. Actually, I'm blocked from Facebook again. I always get blocked because I make also a lot of jokes about the right extreme party in Vienna. And they always, yeah, they try to block me from Facebook. And again, I just realized a few minutes ago, I'm already again blocked for 3 days because I made a quite harmless joke about the presidential candidate a few weeks ago because he's a bit skeptical. He got 50% in the votings almost. And he's a bit skeptical about abortion, about the women's right to abort. And then I made a joke. I just said, I have to get off the pill now because I want to abort a few times before Hitler becomes president. And I got a big shitstorm from right extremes. And now I'm blocked again. I can look on Facebook, but I can't post anymore. Yeah, I just wanted to show this supermarket video. Just as a, so you get an impression. Sorry. Ah ja, hier. I will.
Müssen auch nicht kennen.
yeah, so this is what I'm doing, just reporting about my everyday life. Yeah, and because it, yeah, I also do cartoons, and I published 2 books out of these texts. And yeah, now I have like 30,000 followers. And since then I realized I really enjoy power. Since then I feel really powerful, and I realized I really like this feeling. I like power. And yeah, and before, my readers were mostly hipster and leftists and artists. So I didn't feel a need to post anything politically, because I thought, yeah, they have the same opinion as me, so why should I post something? But now, since my audience grew bigger, I'm making a lot of jokes about the right-wing party the whole time, because also it's growing bigger and bigger in Austria. Yeah. And yeah, they attack me all the time, blah, blah, blah. And I don't know if it has really a positive influence on anything. I just think I make him angrier and angrier. I don't really know if this changes anything, but for me it's a lot of fun, so yeah. And also I think sometimes it helps to take off their masks a bit, because like a few days ago the leader of the right-wing youth in Vienna from the FPÖ posted, why is Sargnagel not already locked in? So yeah, they would lock me in if they would get more power. Yeah. Yeah, but I wouldn't consider myself a political author, because as Stephen said yesterday, I also have a quite pragmatic view on this. I think, yeah, if you want to be political, you have to join real politics and organize yourself. I think I just like the action, actually, and just, yeah, annoy people. Yeah. Yeah, and now this kind of joking on the internet became my profession, so I make readings from that, but I'm always alone. I work on my own the whole time, and I realized that I don't really enjoy working alone all the time, so I thought I would like to have, because I actually like sometimes the aesthetics of chauvinistic fascist organizations, because they have some kind of strength and power, and I thought I would really like to have a fraternity, because we have in Austria this tradition of right-wing fraternities, yeah, academic organizations where women are excluded, and yeah, the whole neo-fascist young men organize and network. And so I thought I would like to have a fraternity of female artists and copy their style, and because I think it's, yeah, very empowering somehow. And we did that. I have now a fraternity. I had the idea a few weeks ago, and it was only an idea, but a friend of mine, a painter, she started to take the idea seriously, and now we're like 100 women, and we're having a fraternity. And the other fraternities are already reacting. They communicated death threats to us, and said we're all just fat, unfucked lesbians, and we're disabled, also they said that. Which is also, I think, kind of funny, because for me it feels like, yeah, dance little puppets, that's actually what we wanted, to annoy them. And yeah, I thought I'd just talk about this fraternity. We don't really know where this is going, because we are still in the organizing process, but and we really have to be careful that we don't really become fascists, because the vibe is really critical right now. And a lot of people think we are a satirical project, but we are really not. And yeah, and we do what fraternities do. We meet and sing songs and walk on the streets, and we have a uniform already. Yeah. And I thought I show you the song, maybe. It's also a video. it's a video of our first big meeting. I just want to show it. And I thought I translate the song text, maybe. But it's not good translated, but I just want to give you an impression. Our song is like, we are called Burschenschaft Hysteria. fraternity hysteria. Yeah, and the text is hysteria, fraternity is here. We like to drink a lot of beer. We like to drink wine and suppress men. The hysteria fraternity is here. The whole country is afraid of us. We are well known for our cheerfulness. When we are really cheerful, you will regret your life. In our space, I don't know, in our meeting point, there's always something going on. Our parties are really famous. We spread our seats everywhere for the golden matriarchy. Till we lead the world, a few heads have to roll off to the golden matriarchy. Our boys are always ready. We call ourselves boys because we want to take it away from them. Yeah, our boys are always ready. Loyalty, honor, power, unity. Every man is happy who can serve us with humility. Hysteria for eternity. Yeah. That's it. Yeah, I'm sure they will come in. Sorry. Actually, yeah, to become the most powerful fraternity in Vienna. Yeah, that's it actually. And we also think matriarchy is actually really the solution of many problems politically, because this whole growing of the right-wing parties in Europe, it's like a concurrence between two patriarchies, because they're afraid of Islamic patriarchy and. Because they want to keep the right to abuse the woman themselves, you know, and yeah, and so we think the only thing we can do is go for matriarchy, yeah.